Hi, and welcome back to PixelPia. This will be the last tutorial in my series about Google Calendar for this time. And today we are going to talk about creating multiple calendars and sharing calendars. But before we move over to my computer, let's talk about when you want to share a calendar. There can be several reasons. Maybe you want to create a family calendar where each person in your family can add their activities and their events, so you have an overview of what all members of your family are doing. Or maybe you have a project calendar where you are a group of people that do work together and you can have a common calendar. Or maybe in your work, do appointments with people. In that case, you can create a public calendar where people can go in and book appointments with you. So with that said, there are some things you need to think about when it comes to permissions for shared calendars. But we will look at those as we go through this on the computer. So let's move right over to my calendar. And here we are in the calendar we have been working on. This is my basic calendar where I have events. But let's say that I want to create a family calendar that's separate from this one. We go on the left-hand side here down to where it says other calendars, and we hit the little plus sign. And there you see subscribe to calendar, create a new calendar, browse calendars of interest, and those are public calendars that you can subscribe to, or from URL or import from another place. We are going to create a new calendar here. Family calendar, we call it, and everyone's schedule. And we have the time set, and I am the owner. So I create that calendar, and it's in progress. So now we go back to our calendars, and here we see the family calendar showed up to the left here. Now we need to go in and change the settings for this calendar. So that first part is exactly as we set it. Then we have auto accept invitations. I want to have this because I will send an invitation to all my family members. Then we have make available public. If it is a personal calendar, never put that out. This is only if you have a calendar, for example, where people can make appointments. Or if I was to make a separate calendar for my YouTube channel where I put all the different past and upcoming tutorials so people can go in and look at it, that could be a public calendar. If I set it to public, I can get a shareable link for that. And then we have share with specific people or groups. And let's add the geeky boomer here. And then we can go down and set the permissions. And this is important. This could be they can only see when I have busy time and when I'm free. They can see all the events. They can make changes to events, or they can make changes and manage sharing. If it's my family and I trust them, I would probably say make changes and manage sharing, so they have control, just as I have, of the calendar. And then we send that invitation, and I can add more people. Event notification, that is if I want notification for that. And then receive email notification when changes are made. So here I can set if I want to know when someone add an event, if I want to know that someone changed an event or canceled an event, if someone replied to an event, responded, or if I want daily emails about the events for that day in the calendar. And you can choose email or none for all of this. And here we have the link to this particular calendar if you want to put it out somewhere. And at the bottom here, you have, if you are subscribed to someone's calendar that you're not the owner of, you can go in and unsubscribe here. And if you want to delete a calendar, totally delete it, you can do that from this page as well. So now we have set up the rules for this calendar in settings. Now let's go back, and I want to do one more thing for this calendar. I want to change the color of the family calendar. I want the family calendar to be in red. So next Sunday at 4 o'clock. So I click at 4 o'clock there. I want to add a family day where I want everybody to be present. Sunday, September 3rd, between 4 and 5. It's an event. I can do as I always did, add guest, add location. But since this is a shared calendar, they will be informed. And down here at the bottom, you see we can change the calendar to family calendar. And that's important because if I don't change that, it will show up in my calendar, but not in the shared calendar. And you're busy and nothing specific here we need to do. And click save. Now I'm going to log in as the Geeky Boomer. And first we're going to check the email, and then we're going to take a look at the calendar. And here we see tutorials. PixelPia have shared a calendar with you. So here I click add this calendar. So here you see, here is my calendar as the Geeky Boomer. And here is the family calendar. So let me see what's happening in the family calendar. There we have a family dinner. Let's say that I want to add something to this calendar. I go in here and I make sure I am in family calendar. And I want to add an event that I am on a conference. And it is an all day, so I don't need to add time. I don't need to add a location because they don't need to know where I am. They just need to know that I'm gone. So here is my conference in the family calendar. We're saving it in family calendar. So now let's go back to my calendar here and refresh it. I'm going to click off the personal calendar. So now I'm just looking at the family calendar. So here we have the family dinner. And here we have a conference all day created by the Geeky Boomer. So now I know that that part of the family is not available this specific day because it's a full day conference. And I can use these calendars to click on or off. Now I see only PixelPia. Now I see both of them in the same calendar. I hope you have learned something from this short series about Google Calendar. I had a little poll on my community tab, what you wanted me to talk about next. I got a couple of answers, but there are still time to answer. I will have a link to that poll in my description of today's video. If you will be part of the decision where we move from Google Calendar. I also want to inform you all that on Monday nights at 10 p.m. Central Standard Time, I have started to do live streams. Those Monday night live streams, I am talking about different aspects of AI, artificial intelligence. So far, we have talked about AI in Google, AI in. We have talked about using AI for writing, for imagery, and for video creation. And next Monday, we are going to talk about AI tools for creating websites. If you are curious about my take on these topics and you don't can attend the live stream, all of them are still public on my channel. Until next time, bye.